November 3rd, Daily Video Bible Reading from the Net Bible, 2 Peter chapter 3 of the New Testament. Dear friends, this is already the second letter I have written you, in which I am trying to stir up your pure mind by way of reminder. I want you to recall both the predictions foretold by the holy prophets and the commandment of the Lord and Savior through your apostles. Above all, understand this. In the last days, blatant scoffers will come, being propelled by their own evil urges and saying, "Where is his promised return? For ever since our ancestors died, all things have continued as they were from the beginning of creation." For they deliberately suppress this fact that by the word of God, heavens existed long ago, and an earth was formed out of water and by means of water. Through these things, the world existing at that time was destroyed when it was deluged with water. But by the same word, the present heavens and earth have been reserved for fire, by being kept for the day of judgment and destruction of the ungodly. Now, dear friends, do not let this one thing escape your notice, that a single day is like a thousand years with the Lord, and a thousand years are like a single day. The Lord is not slow concerning his promise, as some regard slowness, but is being patient towards you, because he does not wish for any to perish, but for all to come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief. When it comes, the heavens will disappear with a horrific noise, and the celestial bodies will melt away in a blaze, and the earth and every deed done on it will be laid bare. Since all these things are to melt away in this manner, what sort of people must we be, conducting our lives in holiness and godliness, while waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God? Because of this day, the heavens will be burned up and dissolve, and the celestial bodies will melt away in a blaze. But according to his promise, we are waiting for new heavens and a new earth, in which righteousness truly resides. Therefore, dear friends, since you are waiting for these things, strive to be found at peace, without spot or blemish, when you come into his presence. And regard the patience of our Lord as salvation, just as also our dear brother Paul wrote to you, according to the wisdom given to him, speaking of these things in all his letters. Some things in these letters are hard to understand, things that ignorant and unstable twist to their own destruction, as they also do to the rest of the scriptures. Therefore, dear friends, since you have been forewarned, be on your guard that you do not get led astray by the error of these unprincipled men and fall from your firm grasp on the truth, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be the honor, both now and on that eternal day. God, I love verse 9 in here where it says, "The Lord is not slow concerning his promise, as some regard slowness, but is being patient towards you, because he does not wish for any to perish, but for all to come to repentance." And I love that because you already foreknow what's going to happen in the world. You already foreordained what is going to happen in the world. You know when your son is coming back. But you're also saying, I already know that you, as my children, can hasten his return. You can tell other people about the gospel. You can pray for other people to follow me in their hearts and in their lives. And I love this because sometimes we can miss things and we can make it all about us, that it's our responsibility for salvation. It's up to us whether we choose it. And it's our responsibility to do these things on earth so that other people can have salvation. And it definitely doesn't take the pressure, I guess I should say, off of us. But we need to understand that ultimately you're in charge. You already know who the elect are. You already know what's going to happen at the end of the world. You already know when the end of the world is coming. You already are in control of all those things. Where the pieces that we miss is, then why do we have to do these things? Why do we have to tell other people about the gospel? Why do we have to be obedient? Why do we have to be humble? Why do we have to pray? Why do we have to do all these things if you already know who the elect are? And that's where we miss the point. You're looking for our obedience. You're looking for our humbleness to be in that relationship with you. And as until we get to that point where we understand that we need to lay everything down at your feet and say, God, I am just completely yours. Take everything else away from me. The person you created me to be, that's all I want to be, and I want to be yours. I want to reflect your goodness and your gracefulness and your forgiveness and your kindness and most of all your love. Verses like this are so incredibly powerful, and so often we shortchange your incredibly powerful message by making it all about us. And it's not. It is all about your sovereignty in this world and just how big and how amazing you truly are. So God, today, let us just lay everything down at your feet, be obedient, and so thankful for all that you have given us, even though we don't deserve any of it. Your power, your love, your forgiveness are all the things that I seek, God, and I hope that I can continue to reflect those in my life. In your son's name I pray. Amen.